fire ripped through a townhome community overnight, destroying families' homes, sending a young child to the hospital. Good evening, and thank you so much for joining us. I'm Tom Haynes.
And I'm Marissa Mitchell in for Sinead Simpson. Now, everyone got out of the townhomes on Rankin Street alive, but Fox 5 has learned that young child was taken to an area hospital for smoke inhalation.
Fox 5's Patty Pan joins us live now from that community tonight. And Patty, we understand that the Red Cross is helping the victims.
Yeah, the Red Cross tonight helping five families displaced in this fire. We're told that their units were destroyed, deemed unsafe to enter or even live in. Now, take a look at where I'm standing. This is probably the worst of the units. Just take a look at all this debris that's now left behind.
They were trying to get the kids out. They got the kids out. Thank God, you know. I was scared for them, and I was scared for us.
Shalonda Sims is among those displaced following a fire overnight at the Rankin Street townhomes in Stone Mountain. She tells Fox 5 it was just after 11:30 Sunday night when she heard her neighbor outside.
When we was finna fall asleep, get ready to go to bed, I heard a girl, a lady come outside. She started screaming. She was like, get the kids, get the kids, get the kids.
Sims says her neighbor in the unit next door had a pot on the stove, and that's what started the fire. In fact, she says the fire was spreading so fast she couldn't sit around waiting for help to arrive.
I came outside. I ran to the firehouse, the fire station, because they were taking too long.
Firefighters spent a good part of the overnight hours battling the blaze, even coming at it from the top.
They had to get on top of the roof and try to put it out, but it kept spreading. They were breaking the glasses with the hammer and stuff.
We're told one unit had major fire damage and five other units have smoke and water damage, including Sims's home. Just take a look at what's left of a number of the units. From the back, it's hard to miss the charred siding that runs between the units. Smoke and soot cover the brick wall and the hollowed out units with scorched debris covering just about every inch of the doorway. We found these bright yellow signs posted on the doors, deeming the units unsafe to live in or even to enter.